So this video will explain the positioning, the pressure, and how to read the report. So consider this is a patient's hand, and we know that this is a exact location of vat, pitta, and kapha points. So I'm feeling the pulse of this particular patient. Because this patient is female, I'm taking the nadi on left hand. I see that her vata location is here, pitta is here, and kapha is here. So there are various ways to take the nadi. What we are following is as follows. I put the sensors or my fingertips at this moment like this. I'm not applying any pressure. I will learn myself to apply pressure 7 to 8 times. This is level 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. At every pressure level, I feel the pulse differently. In Nadi Tarangini, what we are doing is, we are collecting the data at level 2 or level 3. So I'll do the same thing along with the sensors. I'm not switching on the phone yet. I just want to show you how the sensors are to put. So this is the positioning now. Please see that my fingertips are slightly out from this particular unit. Do not put your fingertips like this. Put it like this so that the pressure cannot be applied. Also see that my thumb is in this particular area to get the grip from the bottom. So I'm putting the sensors, I'm not applying pressure at all. Now I start applying 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. How not to put the sensors? So if you put sensors like this, you can see that there is some air gap from here. The air gap is not good to collect the nadi. You cannot put like this also. The sensors cannot be like this, like this. If my nadi is here, I'm just drawing with my nail. If my nadi is here, please understand that the center points of these sensors should exactly go on those locations so that the nadi is good. What we generally follow is we keep one fingertip and then sense the sensor, keep the sensors from here. Also, I have this particular area. Usually the nadi is exactly in between of this. So this is what we follow, but you can do as you have been studied. So the positioning is this. I know how much to put the pressure now. What I'm going to show first is what a nadi looks like. A typical nadi looks like this. The other fashion could be, or so understand, if my vata location can, if I feel the pulse at vata location, I will get the waveform as one of the three. If I can feel it at pitta location, I will get one of these three at the second location, and same as third. I will not get all three waveforms like this if I cannot feel it here. So at the sensors at which I feel the pulse, I will get the waveform. So these are the correct waveforms. Suppose a nadi is not available. For example, at this moment, for this particular patient, I do not feel anything for this finger, which is a kapha finger. So for here, the nadi will be seen something like this. So there could be some pattern or no pattern or absolutely zero pattern. So now we have understood the correct and incorrect patterns. I will show you how to get the nadi and the report card. So I have already filled in all the details about the patient and I am now collecting the data. So first I will show you that I am not keeping the sensors correctly and so the nadi does not come. Or so the report card also does not go. I'm putting at the correct locations, but I'm not applying any pressure. My pressure is zero. So that's why I'm getting all these patterns as good as these and not as this. This is a typical rhythmic pattern. Now I'm keeping at the wrong position but applying good pressure. Still, I do not get a good pattern. You can observe here. It just, you know, going randomly. Now I'm putting like here, which is again not a correct location. And also I'm not putting my thumb under the under her wrist. Or if I am keeping at the correct location, pressure is also correct, but there is some air gap. You can see that there is some air gap here. So even then, the pattern is not correct. So you observe that the sensors have to be correct, pressure, thumb and everything. So now, because all the collection was not correct, even though I have collected for over a minute, if I want to see this particular report card, what I see is that it's still calculating. So in this case, all three waveforms, that is Vat, Pit and Kaph, all three were of so and so form. None of them were of this form where there is a typical good structure. So when you not get good structure in either Vat or Pit or Kaph, when you get all three like this, you do not get a report card. Observed, because the sensors were not placed correctly, the report card did not come. So I'm doing it again. So assume that I have put all the data correctly. I am restarting the device. And now I will show you how to collect the data. So I will feel the pulse first. I know where to put the sensors. My fingertips are out, my thumb is below, and now I'm collecting the data. So you can observe that the rhythmic pattern is available in Vat and Pit. So I have collected data over 1 minute. I'll stop the device. Now it will calculate the results. I'll also recommend that while capturing the data, both the doctor as well as patient will not talk. So once the calculations are done, you'll get the report card. So observe that Vat, Pit and Kaph, all nadis have come, and now you already know how to read the report card and how to look into it and finally print the report card. I hope this video helps to understand how not to collect the data and how to place the sensors correctly to reach to the report card.